the evangelizing lost, revive the saved, setting captives free, all by exalting the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Welcome in. Welcome in to Chain Breakers. And you said, time is winding up. Come on, let's give praise. Come on.
Go to, because
after I give you all the verses, it's going to speak for itself.
Yes, sir.
Go to Romans 1. Go to Romans 1 and 28.
Amen.
Romans 1 and 28. God going to get his word across despite what the enemy's trying to do. Amen. God's word is going to be preached. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. God's word is going to be preached in the presence of his people.
Amen.
Oh, amen. God's word is going to be preached. Romans, like I said, Romans 1:28.
Yeah.
Romans 1:28. Yeah. You say amen when you get it. Amen. Amen when you get it.
Amen.
And it reads thusly, even as they refuse to have God in their knowledge, God give them up to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not fit.
Amen.
That's right.
I want you to look at a neighbor, and I want you out there in Facebook land to call a neighbor, call a friend, call an enemy. That God said the topic, there is a window. Call your neighbor, call a friend. Look at your neighbor and tell them God said there is a window. Now, God, we know if you're Bible scholars and you're Bible students, we know that God doesn't work in time. Mm-hmm. But turn to your neighbor and say, we on the clock. We on the clock. God doesn't work in time.
Amen.
1,000 years is like a day. A day is 1,000 days unto the Lord. Amen. So God ain't in our time. But there's a window for me and you. Amen.
That's right.
And so when God gave me the message and he told me there is a window and he pointed me to Pharaoh. And it was kind of perplexing to me because he said, God hardened Pharaoh's heart.
Amen.
I said, just God? A merciful God? His mercy endures forever? And God, why are you telling me that you hardened Pharaoh's heart? That's what he kept saying to me. He hardened Pharaoh's heart. You know, there's some hard sayings in the Bible.
Yeah.
Just like that Romans 1:28. It said, God gave them up.
That's right.
Oh, no, God didn't give up on those people. God, no, not the merciful God. That God, you tell me that mercy endures for all generations. You tell me he said very hard and fearful heart. Then he goes to Romans. He jump, skip, and hop into Romans. And he says, I give them up. Not God, not the merciful God that we know. That the God we know. That the God that we hear about all the time.
That's right.
That he gave them up. He hardened somebody's heart. No, that ain't the God. That's why I said at the beginning, I had to do some deep studying because for years I've heard how Pharaoh's heart was hard. But I didn't know that God hardened Pharaoh's heart.
Oh, yeah.
You know, for years, I was thinking, oh, yeah, Pharaoh's heart got hard. It kept hardening because he wouldn't let the people of God go for years. That's what I was thinking. Because of plagues and stuff like that. Pharaoh's heart got hardened against God, and he was hardened. No, the Bible said God hardened Pharaoh's heart. So I had to do some research. So I had to do some studying to why God hardened Pharaoh's heart, and to why God was telling me that there is a window.
Yeah.
Well, after I did my research and my studies, I had to go back into the book of Genesis. I had to go back and study Joseph and what Joseph's journey was from the pit to the palace and how Joseph, he lived his life before God. Well, when you continue to read, and if you, it's interesting reading, if you get in Genesis starting at chapter 37, you see how Joseph got taken down, how that's sold into slavery, and how he got taken down into Egypt.
That's right.
And how Joseph became the governor of Egypt. And that Pharaoh was good to the people of God. That Pharaoh had mercy. That Pharaoh was real polite. That Pharaoh did what we call right in the sight of God. But now, when you get down in Exodus, the Bible tells you that Pharaoh died. And then there arose another Pharaoh. There arose another Pharaoh that didn't know Joseph.
All right.
And that Pharaoh dealt hard.
that Pharaoh started dealing harshly. Now, I want you to remember that Pharaoh, because that Pharaoh did right in the sight of God, and he treated the people of God with mercy and kindness. But now his son came along, and he started treating the people of God harshly. All right. And remember this, we have free will. So now, that Pharaoh, I thought I had to keep studying. Now the Pharaoh that arose and was treating the people of God, he died. Because I thought he went on, but he died. Then his son came along. So his son carried out his sin.
That's right. All right.
His son came and he did evil in the sight of God by treating the people of God harshly. Mm-hmm. Remember my message, there is a window. Mm-hmm. Now what God sees that we won't see, that's what God said. God look at the, men look at the outer appearance, but God looks upon the heart of man.
Right.
So for years, for hundreds of years, this Pharaoh had a chance to do right in the sight of God. Mm-hmm. This Pharaoh that came after his dad didn't do like his granddad that treated the people of God fairly and treated the people of God right. Now this Pharaoh carried on the sin. So now when we get in the book of Exodus, and now when you go into chapter 3 and chapter 4, you're going to see all throughout our scene where the Bible says God hardened Pharaoh's heart. So what happens sometimes, saints of God? God will give you exactly what you want. Amen. He continued in his sin. So what God did, God fortified him in his sin. He kept on doing what was not right in the sight of God. And if you read all through the book of Exodus, it says God hardened Pharaoh's heart. I think I maybe seen it one time where Pharaoh's heart was hard because of the plagues that God sent on him. But no, that wasn't the case. God hardened himself because God had already seen in his full wisdom and his full knowledge that this man already had time. His window of time is now closed. He already had time, hundreds of years. He had kept the people of God under bondage. Mm. Hundreds of years. He had to change and get himself right. Like some of you see stuff happening, and you see what's going on, and you've got time, but you got to understand, remind somebody, there is a window.
Yes.
So now when we get to what I'm talking about this morning, where we say, where God hardened Pharaoh's heart, and I couldn't come to understand, but now when I go back and I look, he had hundreds of years to get his heart right. He had all that time. He had the people in. But then again, you keep praying. And the Bible says that the prayers of the people of God, the prayers of the people of God came up before God. And then God rose up Moses.
Moses, yes.
And when God was getting ready to send Moses out to Pharaoh, he told Moses, I'm pretty sure he ain't going to let the people go. God raised Moses up to go tell Pharaoh to let the people go. And before he lets them go, he tells Moses, I'm pretty sure the king of Egypt ain't gonna let the people go. But now, so he can know that I am God.
I am.
Come on, preacher.
So he can know that who I am. Who I am. That's what that Moses said. Who shall I say that sent me? He said, tell him I am who I am.
Come on,
preacher.
Jesus. He said, I stand at the door and I knock. In the book of Revelation, he's standing at the door. Right now, he's knocking. You watching the message, you think it's a coincidence. No, it's not a coincidence. I'm trying to tell you, there is a window. My message is simple. I'm going to use some other stuff to go around it, but the message is, there is a window.
Come on, let it be known.
I like Moses, because you know what Moses did? Moses just did what God said. He said, go and tell them to let my people go. God told me to tell you this morning, there is a window. There is a window. And so they're telling you that everything is fine. You keep on living, acting a fool, and living a fool, and then patting on your back, telling you, you're fine. God came to tell you, no, you better reverse that. There's a window for you, man. You on the clock.
Oh, yeah, on the clock. You on the clock. Oh, yes.
Romans 6:1 says, shall we continue in sin that grace may abound?
God forbid.
God forbid that you can continue to act a fool. Because,
come on, preacher. Come on,
Say it. You got all this stuff going on. You got the pandemic and all this stuff going on. You got fires burning up the West Coast and all this stuff. Yeah. You got hurricane on the line and you still acting a fool.
Yeah.
Oh, they're telling you that pastor, that false prophet, telling you you okay, pay you on the back of
come on.
Only way you okay is you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Yeah. So you in the so whatever comes, we let it go. We know we're going to be with Jesus. But if you're not living for the Lord, he ain't telling you.
Come on.
Matthew 24 says there's going to be a bunch of false prophets that come in. They're going to tell you soothing words and stuff like that. And so you ain't going to listen to them. You ain't going to listen to nothing. There's nothing in your mouth. That's disgraceful to you. When you hear the truth now, see right now, your window closing right now. Because right now, what happens if you continue to listen to the truth and you continue to dismiss and reject the truth, guess what? You're saved in your mind now. Now your conscience is being savored. Now you can't even hear the truth right now. That's like Pharaoh. He kept seeing the things of the miracle of God. Now his heart was so hard now, he couldn't even receive the things of God. So you don't reject the things of God to allow him now. And you couldn't, if you come and God himself came to you, if Jesus himself came to you, you would recognize
it.
You have continued to snub your nose up at God.
Yes.
You continue to dismiss God.
Preach.
Just wait a minute. I'm going to repeat this. There ain't no time with God. God's mercy is going to continue. But guess what? There's a window for you. There's a window for you to accept that mercy and the grace that he's given you. Amen. Through his love, through his son, Jesus Christ. There it is. You on a club.
Yeah.
You're on the clock.
Come on,
man. There is a window.
Yes,
I'm going to get back to Moses. I'm going to get back to Freeway, man. Because like I said, it was interesting. Again, I'm telling you guys, it puzzled me because I'm saying, how could God do this to this man? Why is God hardening this man? He ain't going to give this man a chance. It can't get away from me. I'm sorry, Pastor Anthony. Why is God not going to give this man a chance? Why he ain't gonna give him a chance? You want to tell Moses the man out of his heart and he ain't gonna be able to. So then you send Moses to the man, you wiped out his whole land, he ain't got nothing left. The man still is up. Why is God doing this to this man?
Come on.
And so again, we gotta go back. He had hundreds of years. Some of you have had years and years and years and years.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah. just for the Egyptians. That's what you're thinking of. Oh, God just did that for Pharaoh. He did that to the Egyptians. Yeah, when God do this, when God is doing what he do, oh, that's just for the unbelievers.
Yeah.
No, no, God doing it for you too.
Right.
And I'm approving it. I'm approving God doing just doing it for you too, because in the book of Numbers, chapter 13,
all right,
the Bible says this. The people of God, now they done left Egyptian bondage.
Uh-huh.
They go out. God is taking them into Canaan land.
Take your time.
They start griping, complaining.
Griping, complaining.
Rebelling
yes.
again. Now, they done seen all the stuff that happened in the land of Egypt.
Yes.
They had a bird's eye view of what God doing to the people.
What
yes. But God got them safe in the land, what they call Goshen. God got them safe in Goshen. Ain't nothing happened to them.
Uh-huh.
But you done see God done destroyed the whole land of Egypt.
Amen.
Egypt is really nothing when you leave. Now you get out in the wilderness. He telling you, go. Now you rebelling against right. Moses.
Come on. Come on.
You seen all the signs. You seen all the wonders.
Yes.
Now you get out there. Now you start cutting the food.
Yes.
Come on, preacher.
Yes. Yes.
God free it.
You
yes.
start eating. You start rebelling. You start yes. being disobedient. You start having a lack of faith.
Come on.
You know what the Bible said? They turned an 11-day journey into 40 years.
Yes.
Guess what? The windows closed on them. They didn't even make it to the
yes. Come on here.
A whole generation. The window closed. They didn't even make it to the promised land.
Yes.
Come on.
So God did that to his people. That's the people in the church. That was his people.
Yes, right. Yes.
So you think all the signs again, you think all the signs of them, you see this stuff happening out here. Oh, that's just for the world. No, that's for me and you too.
That's right.
We need to get ourselves straight also.
That's right.
We need to stop cutting the fool also.
Yes,
that's right.
We need to be seeking God more. We need to be on our faces more. We need to be reading the word of God more. We need to be preparing ourselves more, amen.
That's right. Say it again.
Because the window, Jamal, come on, get ready to get me out of here. Jamal, get ready to get me out. Because the window is actually doing what?
Closing.
That's right. But the only thing God is saying, just make sure you're ready. The window can close. But we got to make sure that we're ready.
Hey.
We got to make sure that we're ready.
Thank you, Lord.
Time.
Time is
one. So just have this. Every time that you reject God, just remember this. Every time that you reject God, you keep this in your window gets smaller.
Yes.
But God is the same today. He said in Romans, because they refused to acknowledge him as God.
Oh,
he said he gives them up.
Yes.
To do the thing that they wanted to do. So just remember, God will ultimately give you what you want. Come on.
Yes.
And you want to be a sin of God, but it's hard you so you can sin just like you want to sin.
That's right.
Oh, but you don't have to go down like that. It doesn't have to go down like that, amen.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. God's grace and mercy is on your life right now. You still
yes,
have time.
Yes,
you still
yes.
have time to accept Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Lord, grace, amen.
Thank you, Lord.
For grace and mercy is still open to you right now.
Right now.
So right now, I want to say to you, don't dismiss him again.
Yes.
Don't dismiss him again. You heard the word
from
God. You heard a word from God. Don't dismiss him again. Let's give God a hand clap of praise.
Oh, yeah.
May God bless you. May God bless you, and may God keep you.